Okay.
Let's talk about Le Chatelier's principal. Like I said, old dead guy, Le Chatelier. He came up with this idea of how to push reactions one way or the other, reactions that are in equilibrium. Because, of course, when we're thinking about a reaction in equilibrium, we're actually thinking about two different reactions happening at the same time. The reaction going from HI to H2 and I2, and conversely, the reaction of H2I2 going to HI. Because the equilibrium constant of this is higher than 1, this reaction, the product reaction, the reaction going to the right, is happening to a greater extent than the reaction going to the left, okay? At equilibrium, okay? Once you get to equilibrium. So, in other words, right, the concentrations of these things are higher, and you can see them, right, through the concentration. Anyways, what Le Chatelier figured out was that if you add something or take something away, you can push the reaction back or forth, okay? So in other words, if you were, in this case, to add HI, right? So you increase the concentration of reactants, that'll push the reaction that way, okay? That's because the reaction feels that there's too much of this and it wants to react, okay? It's got too high of a concentration. The equilibrium constant is not met, is what's happening, right? So if we add a bunch of this, we're increasing this value, right? But the equilibrium constant is just that. It's a constant value, right? It's got to be this number, constant. So if we add a bunch of this, is that going to change this number? It's not going to be constant anymore. So what has to happen is this has got to change the concentrations of these to make this back equal to 10, okay? So that's what it's doing. So if you understand what I said there, okay? If not, watch the video, do some Le Chatelier's principle. Okay, anyways, so if I add this, pushes the reaction that way because it increases this, so it'll change that. So it's got to readjust that by, you know, increasing these and decreasing that, right? Because if I added this, pushed the reaction that way, what would happen? We would then decrease this amount, okay? So the other thing is, right, if I wanted to push the reaction this way, right, I could add that stuff, okay? And that would make this bigger, right? That would make this bigger, okay? But then we would say, that's not 10, right? The reaction would say, that's not 10, so I've got to adjust this. I've got to make this bigger and this smaller. So to push the reaction that way, okay? So I could also do the same thing with this. Add it, it'll push the reaction this way, okay? So the basic principle is, right, if I want to make the reaction go this way, I add the products, right? If I want to make it go that way, I add the reactants. Is everybody okay with that? I could do another thing, too. I could remove the reactants, okay? If I take those out of the reaction, that'll push the reaction this way. Why? Because you got to produce more reactants. Why? Because the Ke³ has to always equal 10, okay? So if I took all of them out, would that equal 10 anymore? No, the reaction would be like, wow, I got to produce some more because I need to have this equilibrium constant be 10, okay? That's what the reaction wants to be, is at that 10, okay? And every reaction has its own equilibrium constant, okay? So it's not always going to be 10. Anyway, so I can remove that. That's going to say to these guys, okay, we need to produce more of this, okay? And this is anthropomorphizing these molecules, which they don't really have any feelings and, you know, beliefs and thinking that they need to produce one or the other, just for anybody who's going to be like totally anal out there in YouTube land. Okay, so the other thing I can do is to push the reaction this way, instead of increasing this, right, I can, what? Remove these guys, right? One of these guys, or both of them, right? And that'll take this and push it that way. Okay, because if I don't have any of these guys in there, what's that guy going to say? Oh crap, I need to produce some more products. Okay, is that cool? So Everybody get that? Okay, so the basic tenets, like I said, add and subtract, right, to push the reaction one way or the other. This is how, like, in industry, you do these reactions that aren't super good, that won't go directly to products, right? So what you'll do, you'll do a reaction, and then you'll take out some of the products, right, that you've made, and the reactants keep producing, okay? If you don't take it out, right, then you'll stop the reaction at these concentrations, if that makes any sense, okay? So think about all that. I know it's a lot to digest, okay? Are there any questions right now? Okay, think about it. We'll talk about it probably next time, okay?